Namaste. Myself, Ankita Shreya Prasad. And you are listening to Along With, our NCERT 11th and 12th audio video book, presented by Artskill Passion. Chapter 4, Animal Kingdom. When you look around, you will observe different animals with different structures and forms, as over a million species of animals have been described till now. The need for classification becomes all the more important. The classification also helps in assigning a systematic position to newly described species. 4.1. Basis of classification. In spite of differences in structures and forms of different animals, there are fundamental features common to various individuals in relation to the arrangement of cells, body symmetry, nature of coelom, pattern of digestive, circulatory or reproductive systems. These features are used as the basis of animal classification, and some of them are discussed here. 4.1.1. Level of organization. Although all members of Animalia are multicellular, all of them do not exhibit the same pattern of organization of cells. For example, in sponges, the cells are arranged as loose cell aggregates, that is, they exhibit cellular level of organization. Some division of labor activities occur among the cells. The cylinderates, the arrangement of cells is more complex. Here, the cells performing the same functions are arranged into tissues, hence is called tissue level of organization. A still higher level of organization, that is organ level, is exhibited by members of Platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, where tissues are grouped together to form organs. Each specialized for a particular function in animals like annelids, arthropods, mollusca, echinoderms, chordate organ have associated to form functional systems. Each system concerned with a specific phylological function. This pattern is called organ system level of organization. Organ system in different groups of animals exhibit various patterns of complexities. For example, the digestive system in Platyhelminthes has only a single opening to the outside of the body that serves as both mouth and anus, and is hence called incomplete. A complete digestive system has two openings, mouth and anus. Similarly, the circulatory system may be of two types. First, open type, in which the blood is pumped out of the heart and the cells and tissues are directly bathed in it. And second, closed type, in which the blood is circulated through a series of vessels of varying diameters, arteries, veins and capillaries. 4.1.2. Symmetry. Animals can be categorized on the basis of their symmetry. Sponges are mostly asymmetrical, that is, any plane that passes through the center does not divide them into equal halves. When any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves, it is called radial symmetry. Cylinderates, ctenophores and echinoderms have this kind of body plan. Figure 4.1a. Animals like annelids, arthropods, etc., where the body can be divided into identical left and right halves in only one plane, exhibit bilateral symmetry. Figure 4.1b. 4.1.3. Diploblastic and triploblastic organization. Animals in which the cells are arranged in two embryonic layers, an external ectoderm and an internal ectoderm, are called diploblastic animals. Example, cylinderates, an undifferentiated layer mesoglia is present in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Figure 4.2 showing germinal layer A diploblastic, B triploblastic. Those animals in which the developing embryo has a third germinal layer, mesoderm, in between the ectoderm and endoderm are called triploblastic animals. 4.1.1 Coelom. Presence or absence of a cavity between the body wall and the gut wall is very important in classification. The body cavity which is lined by mesoderm is called coelom. Animals possessing coelom are called coelomates. Example: annelids, mollusca, arthropods, echinoderms, hemichordates and chordates. Figure 4.3a. In some animals, the body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Instead, the mesoderm is present as scattered pouches in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Such a body cavity is called pseudocoelom, and the animals possessing them are called pseudocoelomates. Example: Ascalmanthus. Figure 4.3b. The animals in which the body cavity is absent are called acoelomates. Example: Platyhelminthes. Figure 4.3c. Figure 4.3. Diagrammatic sectional view of acoelomates, B pseudocoelomates, C acoelomate. 4.1.5. Segmentation. In some animals, the body is externally and internally divided into segments with a serial repetition of at least some organs. For example, in earthworm, the body shows this pattern called metameric segmentation, and the phenomena is known as metamerism. 4.1.6 Notochord. Notochord is a mesodermally derived rod-like structure formed on the dorsal side during embryonic development in some animals. Animals with notochord are called chordates, and those animals which do not form this structure are called non-chordates. Example: Porifera to echinoderms. 4.2 Classification of animals. The broad classification of animalia based on common fundamental features as mentioned in the preceding sections is given in figure 4.4. Figure 4.4. Broad classification of animalia based on common fundamental features. The important characteristic features of the different phyla are described. 4.2.1 Phylum Porifera. Members of this phylum are commonly known as sponges. They are generally marine and mostly asymmetrical animals. Figure 4.5. These are primitive multicellular animals and have cellular level of organization. Sponges have a water transport or canal system. Water enters through the minute pores ostia in the body wall into a central cavity, spongocoel, from where it goes out through the osculum. This pathway of water transport is helpful in food gathering, respiration exchange, and removal of waste. Choanocytes or collar cells line the spongocoel and the canals. Digestion is intracellular. The body is supported by a skeleton made up of spicules or spongin fibers. Sexes are not separate. Hermaphrodite, that is, eggs and sperms are produced by the same individuals. Sponges reproduce asexually by fragmentation and sexually by formation of gametes. Fertilization is internal and development is indirect, having a larval stage which is morphologically distinct from the adults. Figure 4.5 Examples of Porifera. A. Cycon. B. Eusporangia. C. Spongilla. Examples: Cycon, Cypha, Spongilla, freshwater sponge, and Eusporangia, both sponge. 4.2.2 Phylum: Coelenterata, Cnidaria. They are aquatic, mostly marine, sessile or free swimming, radially symmetrical animals. Figure 4.6. The name Cnidaria is derived from the nidoblasts or nidocytes, which contain the stinging capsules or nematocysts, present on the tentacles and the body. Nidoblasts are used for anchorage, defense, and for the capture of prey. Figure 4.7. Cnidarians exhibit tissue level of organization and are diploblastic. They have a central gastrovascular cavity with a single opening. Mouth horn hypostome digestion is extracellular and intracellular. Some of the cnidarians, example corals, have a skeleton composed of calcium carbonate. Cnidarians exhibit two basic body forms called polyp and medusa. The former is a sessile and cylindrical form like hydra, adamsia, etc., whereas the latter is umbrella-shaped and free-swimming like Aerilia or jellyfish. Those cnidarians which exist in both forms exhibit alternation of generation, metagenesis, that is, polyps produce medusae asexually and medusae from the polyps sexually. Example, Oblia. Examples, Physalia, Portuguese man of war, Adamsia, sea anemone, Panatula, sea pen, Gorgonia, sea fan, and Mendrinia, brain coral. 4.2.3. Phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophores, commonly known as sea walnuts or coomb jellies, are exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic organism with tissue level of organization. The body bears 8 external rows of ciliated comb plates which helps in locomotion. Figure 4.8. Examples of Ctenophora, Pleurobranchia. Digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. Bioluminescence, the property of a living organism to emit light, is well marked in Ctenophores. Sexes are not separate. Reproduction takes place only by sexual means. Fertilization is external with indirect development. Example, Pleurobranchia and Ctenoplana. 4.2.4. Phylum Platyhelminthes. They have dorsoventrally flattened body, hence are called flatworms. Figure 4.9. These are mostly endoparasites found in animals including human beings. Flatworms are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and acoelomate, and animals with organ level of organization. Hooks and suckers are present in the parasitic form. Some of them absorb nutrients from the host directly through their body surface. Specialized cells called flame cells helps in osmoregulation and excretion. Sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal and development is through many larval stage. Some members like Planaria possesses high regeneration capacity. Examples, Tania, tapeworm, Fascicola, liver fluke. Figure 4.9. Examples of Platyhelminthes, A, tapeworm, B, liver fluke. 4.2.5. Phylum Ascyhelminthes. The body of Ascyhelminthes is circular in cross section, hence the name roundworms. Figure 4.10. They may be free living, aquatic, and terrestrial or parasitic in plants and animals. Roundworms have organ system level of body organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and pseudocoelomates. Animals' alimentary canal is complete with a well-developed muscular pharynx. An excretory tube removes body waste from the body cavity through the excretory pore. Sexes are separate. Dioecious. that is, male and females are distinct. Often, females are longer than males. Fertilization is internal and development may be direct. The young ones resembles the adult or indirect. Example, Ascaris roundworm, Ucheria plerial worm, Anclostoma hookworm. Figure 4.10, examples of Ascaris roundworm. 4.2.6, phylum Annelida. They may be aquatic, marine and freshwater or terrestrial, free living and sometimes parasitic. They exhibit organ system level of body organization and bilateral symmetry. They are triploblastic, metamerically segmented and coelomate animals. Their body surface is distinctly marked out into segments or metamers and hence the phylum name Annelida. Latin Annulus, little ring. Figure 4.11. They possess longitudinal and circular muscles which help in locomotion. Aquatic annelids like Nereids possess lateral appendages, parapodia, which helps in swimming. A closed circular system is present. Nephridia, singular nephridium, help in osmoregulation and excretion. Neural system consists of paired ganglia, singular ganglion, connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. Nereids, an aquatic form, is dioecious, but earthworms and leeches are monoecious. Reproduction is sexual. Examples, Nereids, Ferritima earthworm and Rudinaria. Figure 4.11. Examples of Annelida, A. Nereids, B. Rudinaria. 4.2.7. Phylum Arthropoda. This is the largest phylum of Animalia, which includes insects. Over 2/3 of all named species on Earth are arthropods. Figure 4.12. They have organ system level of organization. They are bilateral, symmetrical, triploblastic, segmented and coelomate animals. The body of arthropods is covered by chitinous exoskeleton. The body consists of head, thorax and abdomen. They have jointed appendages. Arthros, joint, poda, appendages. Respiratory organs are gills, book lungs or tracheal system. Circulatory system is open type. Sensory organ like antenna, eyes, compound are simple. Statocytes or balancing organs are present. Excretion takes place through Malpighian tubules. They are mostly dioecious. Fertilization is usually internal. They are mostly oviparous. Development may be direct or indirect. Example, economically important insects, Apis, honeybee, bombyx, silkworm, Lacifer, lac insects, Vectors, Anopheles, Culex and Aedes, mosquitoes, Gregarious pest, Locusta, locust, living fossil, Limulus, king crab. Figure 4.12. Examples of Arthropoda, A. Locust, B. Butterfly, C. Scorpion, D. Prawn. 4.2.8. Phylum Mollusca. This is the second largest animal phylum, figure 4.13. Molluscans are terrestrial or aquatic, marine or freshwater, having an organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and coelomate animals. Body is covered by a calcareous shell and is unsegmented with a distinct head, muscular foot and visceral hump. A soft and spongy layer of skin forms a mantle over the visceral hump. The space between the hump and mantle is called the mantle cavity, in which feather-like gills are present. They have respiratory and excretory functions. The anterior head regions are sensory tentacles. The mouth contains a file-like rasping organ for feeding called radula. Figure 4.13. Examples of mollusca: A. Pelea. B. Octopus. They are usually dioecious and oviparous with indirect development. Examples: Pelea, apple snail; Pinctada, pearl oyster; Sepia, cuttlefish; Loglio, squid; Octopus, devilfish; Aplysia, sea hare; Dentalium, turkshell; and Cheitoplura, chiton. 4.2.9. Phylum Echinodermata. These animals have an endoskeleton of calcareous ocellus and hence the name Echinodermata, spiny bodies. Figure 4.14. All marine with organ system level of organization, the adult echinoderms are radially symmetrical, but larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic and coelomate animals. Digestive system is complete with mouth on the lower ventral side and anus on the upper dorsal side. The most distinctive features of echinoderms is the presence of water vascular system, which helps in locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. An excretory system is present. Sexes are separate, reproduction is sexual, fertilization is usually external. Development is indirect with free living larva. Example: Asteriasis, starfish, echinus, sea urchin, Antedon, sea lily, Cucumaria, sea cucumber, and Ophiura, beetle star. Figure 4.14. Example of Echinodermata: A. Asterias. B. Ophiura. 4.2.10. Phylum Hemichordata. Hemichordata was earlier considered as a subphylum under phylum Chordata, but now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata. Hemichordates have a rudimentary structure in collar region called stomochord, a structure similar to notochord. This phylum consists of a small group of worm-like marine animals with organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and coelomate animals. The body is cylindrical and is composed of an anterior proboscis, a collar, and a long trunk. Figure 4.15. Circulatory system is of open type. Respiration takes place through gills. Excretory organ is proboscis gland. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect. Example: Balanoglossus and Sacloglossus. 4.2.11. Phylum Chordata. Animals belonging to phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of a notochord, a dorsal hollow nerve cord, and paired pharyngeal gill slits. Figure 4.16. These are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate with organ system level of organization. They possess a postern tail and a closed circulatory system. Table 4.1 presents a comparison of silent features of chordates and non-chordates. Table 4.1. Comparison of chordates and non-chordates. Chordates: notochord is present, central nervous system is dorsal, hollow, and single. Pharynx perforated by gill slits. Heart is ventral. A postanal part, tail, is present. Non-chordates: notochord absent, central nervous system is ventral, solid, and double. Gill slits are absent, heart is dorsal. If present, postanal tail is absent. Phylum Chordata is divided into three subphyla: Urochordata or Tunicata, cephalochordata and vertebrata. Subphyla urochordata and cephalochordata are often referred to as protochordates, figure 4.17, and are exclusively marine. In urochordata, notochord is present only in larval teeth, while in cephalochordata, it extends from head to tail region and is persistent throughout their life. Examples: urochordata, Acidia, Salpha, Dolichium, cephalochordata, Branchiostoma, Amphioxus, or Lancelet. The members of subphylum Vertebrata possesses notochord during the embryonic period. The notochord is replaced by a cartilaginous or bony vertebral column. In the adult, thus all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Beside the basic chordate characters, vertebrates have a ventral muscular heart with 2, 3, or 4 chambers, kidneys for excretion and osmoregulation, and paired appendages which may be fins or limbs. The subphylum Vertebrata is further divided as follows. 4.2.11.1 Class Cyclostomata. All living members of the class Cyclomata are ectoparasites on some fishes. They have an elongated body bearing 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits for respiration. Cyclostomes have a sucking and circular mouth without jaws. Their body is devoid of scales and paired fins, cranium and vertebral column or cartilaginous. Circulation is of closed type. Cyclostomes are marine but migrate for spawning to fresh water. After spawning, within a few days they die. Their larvae, after metamorphosis, return to the ocean. Example: Pteromyzon, lamprey, and myxine hagfish. 4.2.11.2 Class Chondroichthyes. They are marine animals with streamlined body and have cartilaginous endoskeleton. Figure 4.19. Examples of cartilaginous fishes: A. Scolidon, B. Pristis. Mouth is located ventrally. Notochord is persistent throughout life. Gill slits are separate and without operculum. Gill cover. The skin is tough, containing minute palacoid scales. Teeth are modified palacoid scales, which are backwardly directed. Their jaws are very powerful. These animals are predaceous due to the absence of air bladder. They have to swim constantly to avoid sinking. Heart is two-chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. Some of them have electric organs, example torpedo, and some possesses poison sting, example trigon. They are cold-blooded, poikilothermous animals, that is, they lack the capacity to regulate their body temperatures. Sexes are separate. In males, pelvic fins bear claspers. They have internal fertilization and many of them are viviparous. Example: Scolidon, dogfish, Pristis, shawfish, Charchardon, great white shark, Trigon, stingray. 4.2.11.3 Class Osteichthyes. It includes both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton. Their body is streamlined. Mouth is mostly terminal. They have four pairs of gills, which are covered by an operculum on each side. Skin is covered with cycloid, sphenoid scales. Air bladder is present, which regulates buoyancy. Heart is two-chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. They are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is usually external. They are mostly oviparous and development is direct. Example, marine, exocoetus, flying fish, hippocampus, seahorse, freshwater, labio, rorho, cartla, clarias, mager, aquarium, betta, fighting fish, pterophyllum, angelfish. Figure 4.20. Examples of bony fishes: hippocampus, cartla. 4.2.11.4. Class Amphibia. As the name indicates, amphi, dual, bios, life. Amphibians can live in aquatic as well as terrestrial habitats. Figure 4.21. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. Body is divisible into head and trunk. Tail may be present in some. The amphibian skin is moist without scales. The eyes have eyelets. A tympanum represents the ear. Alimentary canal, urinary and reproductive tracts open into a common chamber called cloaca, which opens to the exterior. Respiration by gills, lungs and through skin. The heart is three chambers, two auricles and one ventricle. These are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. They are oviparous and development is indirect. Example, buffalo, toad, rana, frog, hyla, tree frog, salamander, ichthyopus, limbless amphibian. Examples of amphibia, salamandra, B. rana. 4.2.11.5. Class Reptilia. The class name referred to their creeping or crawling mode of locomotion. Latin, repere or reptum, to creep or crawl. They are mostly terrestrial animals and their body is covered by dry and conified skin. Epidermal scales or scutes. They do not have external ear openings. Tympanum represents ear. Limbs, when present, are two pairs. Heart is usually three-chambered, but four-chambered in crocodiles. Reptiles are polychilotomes. Snakes and lizards share their scales as skin cast. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Example, chelone, turtle, testudo, tortoise, chameleon, tree lizard, calotus, garden lizard, crocodilus, crocodile, alligator, hemidactylus, wall lizard, poisonous snakes, naja, cobra, bangerus, craet, vipera, viper. 4.2.11.6. Class Aves. The characteristic features of aves birds are the presence of feathers and most of them can fly except flightless birds. Example, ostrich. They possess beak. Figure 4.23. The forelimbs are modified into wings. The hind limbs generally have scales and are modified for walking, swimming or clasping. The tree branches. Skin is dry without glands except the oil gland at the base of tail. Endoskeleton is fully ossified, bony and the long bones are hollow with air cavities. Pneumatic. The digestive tract of birds has additional chamber. The crop and gizzard heart is completely four-chambered. They are warm-blooded. Homeothermous. Animals, that is, they are able to maintain a constant body temperature. Respiration is by lungs. Air sacs connected to lungs supplement respiration. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous. And development is direct. Example, corvus, crow, columba, pigeon, pistacula, parrot, struthio, ostrich, pavo, peacock, aptidotes, penguin, neophron, vulture. 4.2.11.7 Class Mammalia. They are found in a variety of habitats: polar ice caps, deserts, mountains, forests, grasslands, and dark caves. Some of them have adapted to fly or live in water. The most unique mammalian characteristics is the presence of milk-producing glands, mammary glands, by which the young ones are nourished. They have two pairs of limbs adapted for walking, running, climbing, burrowing, swimming, or flying. Figure 4.24. The skin of mammals is unique in possessing hair. External ears or pinnae are present. Different types of teeth are present in the jaws. Heart is four-chambered. They are homeothermous. Respiration is by lungs. Sexes are separate and fertilization is internal. They are viviparous with few exceptions and development is direct. Oviparous, ornithorhynchus, platypus, viviparous, macropus, kangaroo, pteropus, flying fox, camelus, camel, macaque, monkey, rattus, rat, canis, dog, felis, cat, eliphas, elephant, equus, horse, delphinus, common dolphin, balaenoptera, blue whale, panthera tigris, tiger, panthera, leo, lion. The silent distinguishing features of all phyla under animal kingdom is comprehensively given in the table 4.2. Silent features of different phyla in the animal kingdom.
Thank you for being till the end. I hope this has helped you. If so, give thumbs up, like, share, comment, save, download and subscribe. You can support us by following in other platforms. That link is in the description. Well, thank you. See you later. Maybe never.